People are calling it the yoga tax. DC wants to tax your gym memberships, a lot of things like that. And some people think this is actually a really good idea. Here's how it works. Right now, you only pay in DC on stuff you buy in a store, in a bar, in a restaurant. But if you take the products as a service, you get it tax-free. So here's basically how they break it down. If you buy something like hand weights, you pay the tax. If you buy a gym membership, you don't. If you buy a bottle of water, you pay the tax. If you pay for a water service, you don't pay tax, so you get the idea. So now, well, this seems like a pretty sweet deal for some. Others get totally screwed for a couple reasons. First, as people get wise to this whole service over product thing, more businesses will convert to this model and duck the taxes. Also, the less businesses that foot the taxes, the higher the taxes need to be on the businesses that actually do charge. So you're kind of in a great position if you own a gym, you're in a bad position if you do everything else. If you exempt a large and growing share of economic activity from taxation, then you need to tax the rest at a very high rate to make up the lost revenue. Gym owners and yoga instructors are getting a sweetheart of a deal on this, according to their current tax code. But the inverse of their good deal is that other businesses are being completely penalized and are taking on all this burden.
So this is really interesting because, look, nobody likes taxes. You know, the right wing says, oh, liberals love taxes. Why would we want to pay more taxes, more of our money, right? We don't want that, especially because of all the things that our tax money does go to, wars, et cetera, right? So, but in this case, the question isn't whether you're going to pay more taxes. The question is, how do the taxes get distributed, right? Because the government needs X amount of money no matter what, right? So if they don't tax the services, it creates two different problems, right? One is a distortion in the market because it doesn't make any sense that you pay for a tax on water you get, as you said, at the store, but if you get it delivered to your home, no, that's a service, so there's no tax, right? So that's weird, right? And so it's never a good idea to distort the market in that sense. The other thing is that for a lot of those services, they go to middle class and upper class people, okay? Things like yoga, right? That's a good example of it, right? But there's a whole host of services, legal services, et cetera.
Services, yeah.
Right. So whereas products, a higher percentage of low-income Americans' budget goes towards products, right? So they wind up paying a bigger share of their of their income in taxes because we're only taxing products as opposed to services. So that really, it makes the poor poorer, and it also hits the middle class very hard. It doesn't hit the rich very much at all. Gee, I wonder why we wound up with this system. So so if you do yoga, you're pissed, right? If you have all those services, if you're gonna see new taxes on it, but you gotta remember, it's displacing other taxes you'd have to pay anyway.
Exactly.
And it's a little bit fairer way of doing it.
And you make such a great point because I know myself and a ton of other of my friends and everything, you don't buy services when you can do it yourself at home. Probably less good and cute, but you don't have a choice. So you're absolutely right. I'm not the one, and a lot of people aren't the ones that are going, it's just easier when they bring the water to my door. Like I don't have that luxury, and a lot of people don't.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. And so that's why the federal income tax is actually a little bit fairer because it taxes you based on your income as opposed to the money you spend. Because the poorer you are, the bigger percentage of your income you're going to spend right away. And then you get taxed even more on that. And that's not fair.